As with all living things, your nervous system is designed to cycle between rest and activity. One part of your mind, your conscious mind, does the watching, thinking, planning, seeking and gathering. Activities that are certainly necessary for your day-to-day survival. While another part of your mind, your unconscious, allows you to rest and recharge. Activities which are necessary for your long-term survival. And you need both. Life is a mixture of doing and not doing. Paying attention and not paying attention. Noticing and not noticing. Holding on and letting go. So at day's end you find that peaceful place, as every living thing does. Taking a break from the activities of living, to allow the mind and body to rest and regenerate. And as you relax, the first thing you may notice is whether or not you can become not aware of any stress or tension. But you don't need to fight your mind, which is always aware of those sensations or feelings. Because as you relax, you can begin to discover that each time you take a breath in, you notice a little tension in your chest. And out, notice that feeling of relaxation. And in, tension. And out, relaxation. So you're always relaxing yourself. Naturally. And the more you pay attention to your breathing, the more relaxed you will feel. And those things can begin to seem further away. Like a flock of birds taking off into the distance. Noticing that sound. Alert but not alert. Noticing but not noticing. Aware but not aware. As your mind drifts, away waves drift from one place to another, and no place in particular. And you drift deeper and deeper into that blue, which can be whatever you want it to be. Such stuff as dreams are made of. The part of your mind that puts things together in a different way. Where forgotten things get remembered in a different way, and connections are discovered in a different way. Like when Einstein was thinking about space and time, and he dreamed he was skiing down a mountainside and noticing how the stars in the sky changed position relative to each other as he sped down that mountainside. Down and down. And when he awoke, he knew that time was relative. And that energy matters, because they are the same thing. And you use an awful lot of energy staying awake. Your mind resorts to every conceivable measure of preventing sleep. Now, If you sleep and rest thoroughly, you will have an oversupply of energy. What would you really like to do with that energy? What constructive or instructive developmental project would you like to undertake to use up that extra daily allotment of energy? You've got to direct it elsewhere, rather than keeping yourself awake. Isn't that what really matters? That nice rest each night is going to replenish your energy. So what matters is, how are you going to use it? And whether you realize it now or later, when you awake, you will realize that you have fallen asleep and learned something of tremendous importance for yourself and your life. More and more relaxed, with every breath you take, deeper and deeper, further and further down, as your mind lets go, so that you can come back later to those things which were keeping you awake, to the realization that it is so much easier to just relax and let go now, as naturally as you're breathing in and out, up and down, down and down.